Welcome to this video. In this video, we're going to learn about the if and the switch functions in SSRS. So let's get started. So let me share you my data set that I have. It's a very simple employee data set. So if I run this data, it'll show me the employee listing over here. Now, the scenario over here is that I want to create a new field or a calculated field whereby it shows me their status of their salary. So let me just bring up this paint. And so I have created this salary range. So if an employee salary is less than 40,000, then their status salary band, you can say it needs to be low. If their salary is less than 80,000, then it's medium. And if it's greater than 80,000, then it is high. In order to achieve this, you can achieve it by using an if statement or also using a switch statement. Now, the switch statement is mostly useful if you have multiple conditions, more than three conditions, I would say it's more useful. And the if condition is if you have two to three conditions, you can use that. We will use both of those conditions in this example. So let's start off with the if statement. Let's go back to our design view. And under the design view, what we're going to do is we're going to go into the data set and we're going to right click on it and we're going to add a calculated field. So let's do that. We're going to enter a name of our data set over here. Maybe I can put it as salary band, and let's go to the expression. So under the expressions, we're going to use an if statement. If you're not sure where the if statement is placed under your category over here, you'll go to common functions. And under your common functions, we're going to go onto your program flow. So when you click on the if statement, you can see there's a small example over here. So it shows you a sample of a very basic if of a scenario over here. So if your yearly income is greater than or equal to 60,000, then you are high, else it is low. So this is a basic if statement over here. What we will do, we will jump onto a nested if statement with an else clause, as this is very simple and you can have a look at this and you can try it as on your own. So what we're going to do is you can double click on it or you can type it, and in brackets, we're going to choose our field. So we'll go onto the fields and then we're going to select our annualized salary, right? And then we're going to put our clause. So if annualized salary is less than 40,000, comma, then it's low. So you're going to put the output in double quotes. Just need to be mindful over here. You need to put the output of it in string. So a string would be required in double quotes. So if you want to go ahead with else, you'll put a comma over here and then you'll put the else clause. However, what we're going to do is we're going to create another if statement. We're going to create a comma. Then go to our program flow, create another if statement. If go to a data set, annualized salary is less than 80, comma, and you put another as medium. And under the else clause, we don't have to put any condition. So we can just put the output directly. And this, in this case, is going to be high. So you don't necessarily have to put the other if statement. This is going to be the last end clause over here. So once you're done, you're going to close your brackets, and you have to be very careful when you're closing your brackets. So this is the first bracket that I have closed. And now what I'm going to close is this bracket that I had created. So I'm going to put one more bracket over here. Click on OK. Click on OK. You're going to insert a column over here. So I'm going to insert that. And my column will be salary band. And now I'm going to run my report. And as you can see over here, it's medium, it's 80,000, that is greater than 80,000, that's high, and if it's below 80,000, that's low. Now, we will learn how to do the same thing using a switch function. So let me go back to our design, and let me insert an interactive sorting over here quickly. If you haven't seen this, I have made a previous video about interactive sorting. That looks fine. And now what we're going to do is we're going to create a switch function. So we're going to create a calculated field. So let's go to calculated fields. Let's add a calculated field over here. Put salary band. I'm going to put underscore, I'm going to put a switch. So under the fx expression, I'm going to click onto that. I'm going to go on my common functions. Under the program flow, I'm going to select a switch. And as you can see in this example over here, the switch function works on multiple conditions, and it's much more easier to use a switch function whenever you have multiple conditions. I would say if you have more than three conditional expression in your problem or in your scenario, go with the switch function. So if I double click on the switch, what it'll ask me to do is create a condition. So I'm going to go to my data set. I'm going to create analyze salary is less than 40,000. I'm going to click on comma and I'm going to put a statement over here. It would be low. So that's my output. And now the difference is that instead of putting a comma and having an if statement over here, like we did in our if function, I'm not going to put any switch function. I'm just going to put a comma and then I'm going to put another clause. And this clause would be if my salary band is less than 80,000, comma, then I'm going to put medium and comma again. Now what I can do is I can go ahead and put another condition over here as the last condition. In this case, it would be if my annual salary is greater than equal to 80,000, then high. However, there's an easier way to do this. You don't have to put the last condition. Instead of the last condition, what you can do is you can type true there. So it's just going to say this to the switch function that if none of this is true, then the last true clause would be output as high. And then you can click on OK. So instead of the last condition, you can just replace that with true. And then it will automatically switch it to, if none of this condition is matched, it will switch to the last condition, which is true over here. In this case is high. So let's click on OK. Let's click on OK and let's look. Let's report. And there you have it. So you have the same expression, one using the if function and the other salary band using the switch function, which does the same job. However, as I said, this is an example. In this example, we have only used three conditions. If you have a scenario where you have to use more than three conditions, you would most likely go with the switch function. So I hope you have enjoyed this video. If so, please do give a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel. I will see you in the next video.